Okay, so I'll be going over all the brand new Claude code news from the last week. There will be timestamps down below, so you can skip ahead to any part you find useful. Firstly, you want to make sure on the latest version of Claude by doing Claude update, and then as of the time of recording, it's 2.0.19. They added a brand new model to model selector, which is Haiku 4.5, and that is basically the like least powerful but fastest version of all the Claude models, and you can see if you do /model right over here. And it's actually just as powerful as Sonnet 4 was when it comes to software engineering, according to this benchmark over here. So you can see Haiku is 73.3 and Sonnet 4 is 72.7 on the software engineering benchmark verified. And with the same performance of Sonnet 4, it's 1/3 of the cost, but more than twice the speed. But some people have found that it's faster than that because this person says that it's 3.5x faster in their experience. I did a tiny bit of testing of the model earlier today, and I have found it to be much faster and just as accurate as Sonnet 4 was when it comes to a small add-on that I'm making for Anki. And that's basically like an AI language conversation like add-on when it comes to Japanese to basically help me learn words better. And I think that for really small code bases and really well-defined tasks, it is performing pretty well, and I will be using it more for that purpose. One thing that I have found quite annoying recently is because often I use Codex CLI for a task, and then Codex CLI can take up to 7 to 10 minutes for the exact same task that is like relatively easy and I would have just given to Haiku instead. But of course, the previous Haiku model was not that good at coding, and it seems they've made it much better and faster. So honestly, I think a pretty viable strategy is that you can use Sonnet 4.5 to come up with changes that should be made, and then use Haiku 4.5 to actually execute on those changes because of its performance when it comes to software engineering and its speed as well. And then you can probably use Codex CLI if you still like to use that for any of the much harder tasks or any of the like persistent bugs that Claude code is not able to solve. So doing something like that may mean that you won't hit your Claude code rate limits quite as much, because of course Haiku 4.5 is 3 times cheaper than Sonnet 4.5. The only smaller disadvantage seems to be that it's still has a context window of around 200,000 tokens, whereas there's a variation of a Sonnet 4.5 which has a context window of 1 million tokens. So they'll probably release 1 million token version soon enough, we'll just have to wait and see. And I think that Opus 4.5 will be released soon enough, because on the Claude code website, the source code, there were 2 brand new models, which are Rainbow Butterfly Stream and Crystal Mountain Breeze. That was like in the JavaScript source code or something like that. And then 2 days later, one of them turns out to be 4.5 Haiku, and I think the remaining one would be 4.5 Opus, unless they come out with a brand new, completely different model instead. They also introduced a brand new Explore Subagent, which is powered by the Haiku model, and it will search for your codebase to efficiently save context. So you can do at and then do explore, and that will trigger the default subagent, which is explore. Then if I press enter within my HyperWhisper codebase, you can see that's going through the codebase pretty quickly, and it's going to provide a comprehensive overview of these components over here. So the project structure, key technologies, main components, architecture patterns, entry points, dependencies, and some notable design decisions as well. And after about 72 seconds, it came up with this pretty comprehensive list of everything. So the project structure, technology stack, and so forth. And yeah, it's like pretty long. This could probably be used to make a claude.md file or a agents.md file or something along those lines. And probably just getting people onboarded with a brand new code base as well. Now, one interesting thing about this brand new Explore Subagent is that it's baked into a Claude code system prompt. You don't have to manually call it every time, because I used ProxyMan to intercept the like request to the Anthropic API endpoint and extract the brand new Claude code system prompt. And in the prompt, it says, when exploring the codebase to gather context or to answer a question that is not a needle query for a specific file class function, it is critical that you use a task tool with subagent type explore instead of running search commands directly. And then you can see right here that it gives some examples. So I think this will probably mean that Claude code is better at finding things within your codebase because of the specific subagent when it comes to making changes in your codebase. Another improvement is that Claude code will auto background long-running bash commands instead of killing them, and you can customize it by setting this environment variable. And that basically means that like when you have your bashes, if you do /bashes, then anytime Claude code runs a command and realizes that it's taking quite long, then it will move it into background so you can continue coding. I have found in some cases Claude code decided to run a command like npm install whatever, and then depending on my internet as well, it may take like 3 or 4 minutes to do that. And if I press escape, then it will kill the command, but I think in this case it will now put it back into background. So if I say something like run npm run dev in the Next.js folder, as a bash command, then it will start running that. And I can press Control B to run it in the background, but I think after a couple of seconds, it will automatically move into the background instead. And it seems that that happens after 30 seconds. If the bash command has not completed running, then it will be moved into the background. And you should see if you do /bashes as a background task. So if you want to change that, you can either go to your environment variables, or you can write export this and then do 15,000, for example, and that will be 15 seconds. They fix a bug where you can toggle MCP servers by doing enter after writing them. So you can do at, for example, shadcn, and that's my MCP server. Press enter, that turns it off. And then doing that again turns it back on. So that can make sure that you're not using too much of your context window with your MCP servers, because you can toggle them on and off when needs be. They also wrote --system prompt. And I think it basically means that when you go to Claude --help, then you can see it's now on the list here, where it says system prompt to use for the session. And that can basically help you override the default system prompt. But if you want to add something to end of the system prompt for that session, then you can do append system prompt instead. And it seems that Claude Code will also be integrated into the mobile version of Claude. You can see some examples of how it will look, because you can select your repository, connect it to your GitHub, and it will appear on the left-hand side in the Claude application, kind of like this. So there will be like a code section, but it has not been released to the general public. So it's kind of like how on the ChatGPT mobile app, you can trigger sessions of Codex on the go and then review on your computer or review on a GitHub as a PR or something like that. And the only time I really find myself using it is when it comes to like, I get an email, a support email saying that there's a certain bug and I'm not on my computer. And then I quickly like tell Codex to find the bug and fix it. And then I review the PR when I get back to my computer and then publish that update. That is the only time I really find myself using it on the go, but I'm sure many other people have different use cases as well. And Claude Code will be releasing a web version of the application soon as well, as you can see here. And that's basically for the video. I do make these videos every time there's a big Claude Code update, so do subscribe to the channel if you do like that kind of stuff. And if you do have a Twitter account, then do consider following me on Twitter. There will be a link down below.